Covered line filters. Covered line filters is a particularly easy in microstrip or strip line forms for bandwidth less than about 20%. Wider bandwidth filters generally require very tightly coupled lines, means that the spacing between the two coupled lines would be very small, which is not practically implemented, which are difficult to fabricate. Effectively, the basic geometry of coupled line filter is two barrel lines over a ground plane like this geometry, and these two lines with lengths, for example, L. Actually, we have different configurations for such coupled line filters. According to the even characteristic impedance and odd characteristic impedance, and the lengths, and the configuration of the coupled line circuit, we can obtain different filters. We are going to discuss it without proof. Assuming that we have coupled line transmission line section, and we have one line section with grounded port and open port on the other side, and we have these two ports 1 and 2. In this case, the input impedance of port 1 would be given in terms of the electrical length theta. Theta here equal beta L, or 2 by L over lambda effective. So the input impedance of port 1 in this case would be given by this equation, while the input impedance of the second port would be given by this equation. If we are going to draw the response of the input impedance or the image impedance of port 1 as a function of theta, which corresponds to the electrical length, we can find that the real value of the impedance start from finite value to infinite value, and go from infinite to finite, and so on. As the finite values means that would be pass band, at infinite value would be stop band. So in this case, we are talking about low pass filter, which is periodically repeated. So here we are talking about low pass filter response. In another way, if we have port 1 from one line and port 2 from the other line, and the two other ports are short circuited, in this case, Z image 1 would equal Z image 2, would have the same response, and will be given by this equation. If we draw this equation as a function of theta, we find that starts from infinity to finite value at theta equal pi over 2, then goes to infinity at pi, and so on. This means that it would be passing when theta equal pi over 2. This would be stop here and stop here. So this is some sort of bandpass filter. And theta equal pi over 2, this corresponds to a length lambda over 2. Lambda over 4. This corresponds to lambda over 4. Pi over 2 corresponds to lambda over 4. So when the length of the coupled line transmission line section here would be lambda over 4, it would be the center of the band pass. Another configuration is similar to this configuration, but in this case it is open circuited. So we have coupled transmission line section. The input would be from one line, and the output would be from the other line, and the two other ports would be open circuited. The input impedance or the image impedance in this case would be this form, And according to this form, we have real impedance equals zero until certain value. Then after a certain value, we have real impedance. So in this case, in this bar, we have imaginary impedance. Imaginary impedance corresponds to stop band. And here we have real impedance. Then we have real impedance equals zero. So this effectively also a bandpass filter. The difference between this type and this type is that here we have a real impedance, but very large real impedance. So we are going from very large real impedance to a moderate real impedance. Here we have imaginary impedance, then go to real impedance, then imaginary impedance. So both of configurations are bandpass, but with two different mechanisms. Another way, if we have Z image 1 from the lower line and Z image 2 from the upper line, and both of them at the same side, and the lower line is open circuited and the lower line is short circuited. So in this case, we have Z image 1 different from Z image 2. Z image 1 would be of this form, and Z image 2 would be in this form. If we are going to draw Z image 1, it would be bandpass filter similar to the previous case. But in this case, we are talking about feeding 1 and 2 from the same side. Other configurations, we have Z image 1 and Z image 1 from the two sides of the same line, and the other coupled line is open circuited. We have Z input here in this form, and this corresponds to all bus response. And other configurations, if it is short circuited, if the two transmission line or two parts of the coupled line are connected to each other, if one is short circuited and the other is open circuited, if both of them are short circuited and are fed from the same side, if both of them are open circuited and they are fed from the same side, all of these are all pass, these are all stop. Okay? Effectively, we are going to concentrate on this configuration, but other configurations can be found in the books, which are mainly designed for coupled line filters. So we are going to concentrate in the configuration. We have feeding from port 1 and port 3, while port 2 and port 4 are open circuit. In this case, the image impedance for port 1 is the same as the image impedance for port 3, which is given by this formula. If the coupled line sections are lambda by 4 lengths, lambda by 4 lengths, it means that theta equal pi over 2. In this case, if theta equal pi over 2, cosine theta it would be 0, and sine theta it would be 1. So in this case, the input impedance at lambda over 4 would be half the even impedance minus the odd impedance. And it should be noted that the even impedance is always greater than from the odd impedance, because the even impedance depends on C11 only, while the odd impedance depends on C11 plus 2C12. And the response here of the input impedance would be real if the value Z not even minus Z not odd squared is greater than z not even plus z not odd squared cosine theta squared, or in other words, would be real if the argument of such a square root is greater than 0. So when it is real, we have real response. When it is imaginary, the input impedance or the real part of the input impedance would be 0. So this would correspond to the cutoff. From this relation, we can determine the value of theta, which correspond to theta 1, or which correspond to the initial frequency of the bandpass, and theta 2, which correspond to the final frequency of the bandpass. This can be determined by equating this argument to 0. So by equating this argument to 0, and finding out the value of theta. So if theta is greater than theta 1, the real impedance would be real, or there would be real impedance, and as long as theta is less than theta. So this can be determined as cosine theta 1 equal minus cosine theta 2 equal z not even minus z not odd over z not even plus z not odd. From this, we can determine the value of theta 1 and theta 2. And effectively, the value of theta naught equal pi over 2. As I said, theta effectively is beta L. So from the value of theta, we can determine the corresponding length here and the corresponding length here with respect to the wavelengths. So, or in other words, we can determine the frequency here and the frequency here. So theta 1 and theta 2 would correspond to F1 and F2, and theta equal pi over 2 would correspond to theta naught or F naught or the center of the bandpass. The phase shift between the output and the input in this case is cosine beta or beta. So the phase shift is z naught plus z naught even plus z naught odd over z naught even or minus z naught odd cosine theta. So beta, the phase shift, is real if theta 1 is less than theta and theta is less than theta, which means that the phase shift from port 1 to port 2 would be a real value if I am inside the bandpass. Okay,